introduction clip. In today's video, I will be reviewing some of the famous summer toners. Like they were quite famous when I bought them a year back or before. And also I will be reviewing some of the acne care products from Innisfree. So the first product of this video is the Face Shop Chia Seed Calming Mist Toner. And this is probably the only Face Shop product so far that has not reacted on my skin. And I have reviewed some Face Shop product in this very old video of mine. Like if you're interested, you can check this out. So this product claims to calm and hydrate your skin, and as for my personal experience, I did find it hydrating, but I didn't see any kind of calming effect. And also I want to mention that this particular product, like this is the old version and this has been renewed to this product over here. Like this old version contained denatured alcohol, and I don't know if they have removed in the latest version or not, but otherwise I did find this product has overall okay, or maybe little bit more than okay. So I feel that everybody out there can try this, except for the very oily skin people living in the hot humid city. And next is the Aromatica Tea Tree Balancing Toner. And this particular toner is made for the oily and acne prone skin. But now you must be wondering, why did I buy this for my dry, sensitive and acne prone skin? And I really don't know. And I guess at that time this was quite famous, and I was looking out for a lightweight acne treating toner for summer, and so I guess I bought it. And for the performance, this is an overall okay product, and I didn't see any kind of good effect or any kind of calming effect on my acne. And this smelled mostly like a tea tree oil, because tea tree oil is used in it. And then I have this the Secret Key Witch Hazel Pore Clear Toner, and this contains some of my favorite ingredients, like Centella Asiatica for calming the skin, snail mucin filtrate to treat and repair the skin, and of course this has witch hazel to tone and clean out your pores. So I also bought this to check whether this works on pores or not, but unfortunately I really couldn't use it, because just after some 3-4 usage I found this bit drying on my skin. And I don't know, this particular toner had a very strong alcoholic scent to it, and so I just couldn't really use it, and I passed it on to my mom, who has very oily and acne prone skin. So she used this up for me and she found it overall okay. And I will say, like, if you are interested, everyone out there can try this, but if you have sensitive skin or if you have very dry skin, this product is not for you. And next I have this very famous Sun and Park Beauty Water. And if you are into serious skincare or into K-beauty, you must have seen this product somewhere in the YouTube or blog or Instagram, like literally everywhere. But in case if you don't know, so let me introduce like what this product is. This product is famous among the makeup artists because they use it on their models before applying any makeup. And this toner is loved by people because it's a multitasker. It works like a skin balancing toner, and it also works amazingly as a deep cleaning toner. And also this works fabulously as a daily exfoliating toner. So you see, it's indeed a multitasker. And this particular, like, I have a travel sized quantity, and it is available in 3 different sizes, like a full 280 ml quantity, then this 60 ml quantity, and a miniature 25 ml quantity. So this was a gift from the website, and I was really excited when I received it. And but after 2-3 usage, the cheek portion on my face started paining from the excessive dryness, and so I stopped using this. And when I checked the ingredient list, I saw that this is loaded with the essential oils, and also it has denatured alcohol somewhere at the bottom. So in case like if you have sensitive skin or very dry skin, I will insist that you try out a sample first or a deluxe sample size. Like since this didn't work on me, I passed it on to my mom who has very oily and acne prone skin, and she loved this toner. Like, so I feel that people who have oily skin or normal skin and combination skin people in hot humid summer can use this. So the next product is the TM My Signature Vita B5 toner, and this is a very simple skin hydrating and calming toner, and the brand TM made this up so that it can be used along with their famous vitamin C serum. Like, I've reviewed their serum in this video over here, you can check it out later. And they made it up so that when the vitamin C serum and this toners are used together, they give really good effect and benefit on your skin in the shortest amount of time. And also the good thing about this toner is it is 100% essential oil free, 100% fragrance free. And so from all the toners that I have reviewed in this video, I feel that this is the best choice for the sensitive skin. And I feel that because of the lightweight consistency, this is perfect for the summer, and I feel all skin types out there can use it. However, like if I have to compare to all the advanced hydrating toners that are available nowadays, and I have reviewed some in this video over here, I feel that in comparison to these toners, this is overall an okay product, and I'm not that blown away by the performance. But if you are on budget and you hate a thick hydrating toner and you are looking out for something lightweight yet very gentle on skin, this is something you can check it out. And now I will be reviewing some useful and some useless products from Innisfree. Like the products which I'm going to review now, some have been really good, while most of them didn't impress me. And the first product is the Innisfree Bija Trouble Lotion. And before I talk in detail about this product, I first want to clear out the confusion among the two different lines from Innisfree. Like, people often get confused between these products. One is the Innisfree Bija Cica line. This particular range is suitable mostly for the sensitive skin. Whereas this Bija Trouble range, which has this green, like faded green color packaging, is mostly suitable for the oily and acne prone skin. So today I have this Bija Trouble Lotion. This is a lightweight lotion, and it contains willow bark extract to calm your skin and keep your pores clean. I bought this particular product for my mom as her summer moisturizer, and as a moisturizer she liked it. Like, it worked amazingly as a lightweight non-sticky moisturizer. However, she didn't notice any kind of effect on calming the acne or reducing the redness. And the next product from the same line is the Innisfree Bija Trouble Spot Essence. This is their spot treatment, and I bought a full size of this one. Like, this is a full size, the 15 ml. I bought this size after using their deluxe sample size, and I really loved it, and that's why I have this full size. And this contains a salicylic acid to calm the acne and to clean out the pores, and also it contains a torio seed oil and medocassocyte to calm your skin and heal your acne. Also it contains a licorice salt to help reduce the redness and brighten up that spot. Like, nowadays there are many advanced spot treatments that I'm using and I'm loving them, but back, I guess 2 years back when I bought it, I really loved it, as it worked amazingly on all my zits, surface acne and pimple. And the next product is the Innisfree Pimple Patches. And if you don't know, yes, Innisfree does carry pimple patches, and this particular one contains 24 hydrochloride pimple patches of different sizes. And as you can see, this is not used up, and it is because these pimple patches has been completely useless. Like, they didn't stick to my skin well, nor they did any kind of extraction, and were like a complete useless product. And also this came along with 10 cotton swab which contained some kind of acne treatment solution, and again this solution never seemed to work on my acne. And the other thing is, like, taking out the solution from inside the cotton swab was how should I say, I always failed at it. And like, in comparison to the Cosrx and the Some By Me pimple patches, this is quite costly. But still I used to get it because at that time Cosrx one were not easily available. And next is the Innisfree Jeju Volcanic Blackhead Out Balm, and this is the blackhead removing product from Innisfree, and it contains this really thick greasy balm which on massaging on your nose, like when it comes in contact with your skin, it heats up and melts down the blackhead in your pore and thereby eases the extraction process. And Innisfree suggests that for the best result, this balm is to be used along with their silicone fingers. And the silicone finger has two different sides. Like, on one side it has this really fine soft brush, and on the other side it contains this grooved surface. So what you do is, with the brush side you apply the balm and massage it, and with the grooved side you extract the blackhead. And for the result, all I can say is I didn't notice anything, and it is because I really didn't use this product, because whenever I used it I always ended up with whiteheads or irritated portion on my nose. The next one is the Innisfree Nail Remover. This is their nail paint removing product, and because I really like it, I have two bottles of it. One is fully empty and second is almost empty. So I really like this over the conventional drugstore nail paint remover, because not only it removes the nail paint efficiently, except for the glitter one, it doesn't even dry out my nails or irritate the skin around my nails. It's very gentle on your nail. It doesn't smell that chemically. Like, it does have some sort of chemical scent, but they have covered it with the citrusy scent. And also I feel that, like, previously I was using the Lakme nail paint remover. In comparison to that, this is like almost similarly priced but with a better performance and better quality. And if you are wondering where you can find this product, I will include the purchase option in the description box below, and also I will be including some useful video for you to check out. And in case if you have used any of these products, comment down below and let me know, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.